We've been talking a lot around what does it take to succeed, around having a mindset for business. And it's also a mindset for life. One of the key things with your mindset is being clear that you've got a growth mindset. Now, a great way to illustrate this is elastic bands. If you look at an elastic band just like this, it's not really good for much as it is. It just is what it is. There's no pressure, it just sits there as it is. And when we talk about having a growth mindset, what it allows us to do is it allows us to stretch. And you see, when we start to stretch, when we start to go outside of just the comfortable zone that we're in, we begin to actually grow as a person. Now, as with any illustrations, there are limitations to it. But if you work with me, if we look at our elastic bands, there is a danger. If you go too far outside your comfort zone, what can actually end up happening is that you can stretch so far that you break. And you can snap. And we talk about people who are snapping, people who are burnt out, people who are exhausted, people who have nervous breakdowns. You don't want to do that. But you do want to have a growth mindset. You want to have a mindset that says, this is what I'm like now. But when I've gone and done something, maybe just on the outside of that, I can be a little bit bigger, a little bit better, and a little bit more, and a little bit more. And as you start to grow, just like the elastic, you know, for an elastic to be effective, you actually want to stretch it so that it can hold whatever it's holding. And it's in that stretch that we get our usefulness. It's in that stretch we find our purpose. So as you start to look at why are you in business, what is it in business that you're doing, it comes down to this whole reason of having a purpose, what we talked about beforehand, knowing yourself, having that solid foundation, that belief in yourself and in what you're doing. And a growth mindset says, what do I need to learn? How do I need to learn it? Where can I learn from? And you get to do things like redefine failure. You don't see failure as this fatal thing. It's like, oh, I failed. Everyone's going to laugh at me. Oh, I'm not going to do it again. You actually see failure as a learning opportunity. The famous invention of the light bulb took 10,000 attempts before it got there. And when asked, Thomas Edison said, I didn't fail 9,999 times or 10,000 times. I found 10,000 ways how not to make a light bulb. There, every single one of those was a learning opportunity. And it's the same with yourself. If you will allow yourself to learn, you will be prepared to step outside your comfort zone. It's outside of that comfort zone that you grow and you learn and you develop as a person. So as we go forward into the exciting adventure that is ahead of you, pick something that you can stretch yourself on. Go outside of that comfort zone every day, just a little bit further and a little bit further, and it will grow. And as it grows, you will grow with it. And who knows what adventure awaits. If any of this resonated with you and you'd like some help with it, do feel free to get in touch. Drop me an email at mike@thinkright.co.nz or 0272 987 523 or our website www.thinkright.co.nz.